What is that sound is very, very, very difficult to say.
It is this amalgamated, shaken but not stirred sort of mixture that...
Contemporary Indian music.
Hello, check. Check. Hey, hey. Thoda aur. Hello, hello, hello. Check. Monitor mein thoda sa dena.
Agam means the inner self. Music comes from within, so we thought maybe it makes sense.
Om Ganara.
We try to bring in Western into Carnatic or Carnatic into Western. So I do the Carnatic music, and then, you know, as you move forward, it actually converges at a point where you actually think, this should have been together.
Swaratma's music
is the sound of India.
Alright, boys and girls, this is the part where we celebrate life.
Bhumi Swarga Agutide Nodu.
Our music is not folk music. It's just, we just use elements of folk, elements of rock, elements of Indian classical, elements of, you know, jazz and other forms of music.
In the last few years, what we have seen is an increasing number of bands and individuals starting to sing and compose music in their own languages as bands.
Name Yodaka itself happens to be a Sanskrit name, and it means warriors.
Shvetambaradharam Devim Shveta Gandhanulepita Vandeham.
All the shlokams are so musical, and it's on meter. It fits on any kind of tune, no? As long as you understand how it flows. We also work together on another project. It's also a performing band. It's called La Pongal. That's like an interesting thing for us to see how folk music sounds in a rock band setup.
The traditional Indian instrument and the Western instrument aren't very different.
Let me show you this folk instrument. This is, we call tintila. But see, I try to put and make it in the up down. Then I can play with any instrument.
I tune it more like an Indian instrumentalist would tune it. And so it gives a, you know, a beautiful drone and...
So the instrument is not what pushes, it's this. Started doing just our own music using a lot of folk and classical influences, but yet, because we were contemporary people in cities, so we're listening to rock and jazz and reggae and all that came into our music. But something very Indian emerged.
We do not follow chord patterns. we go by the Indian way of following scales.
And the minute you start playing in scales with a slightly Indian rhythm, it's amazing that immediately you start sounding Indian.
Just has a way of sounding folky. There's that spirit in folk music that you can't find in some other sort of music sometimes.
Then when you see something that East India Company does, when Papon sings his Bihu, he grew up with Bihu.
You have to be open enough in your mind to let other form of music come and blend with your mindset of music. So I guess fusion happens then.
We are 8 of us working on that plot, working on that song, and trying to make that song sound like 8 of us together.
It's not only Western or Indian, it's about the people who are, you know, who are, you know they find it, you know, a common ground.
When we were doing the first album, we almost consciously tried to make it sound not like an Indian band. And then when we started touring with the first album, these elements used to start creeping inside. And so we put all these rural melodies and juxtaposed it with very, very intense energy.
Like a constantly evolving sound, really. Keep the doors open for new people to walk in, add their colors and sounds and textures. People are very surprised when we go to abroad music festivals, call ourselves Indian music band, and then have these complete rock band setup of bass guitar, electric guitars, acoustic guitar, and then a violin and a drummer, and then play music which is completely Indian and but with rhythms which they can really understand. And
the audience reacts to it from a very emotional point of view. So if something is honest and it's straight from the heart, I think the people will react.
I think it's the economic confidence of the country. I also think it's the fact that so many of our Indians today are truly global citizens.
So all kinds of stuff contributing to this move where the assertion of your own cultural identity is very, very strongly and definitely made. And if the rest of the world doesn't want to listen to us, too bad. We play our own stuff, you like it, you like it. You don't like it, too bad.